Hi everyone, so welcome to another lecture video on pet parenting, the second one, the most important one, nutrition in pets. For students, this is a course in, I think in fifth year or fourth year, you will have a course on nutrition and pets, okay. So this will help you. Actually, we will cover this in two classes. This one is a very basic one, okay. Next one will be more theory one, like the energy requirements, the different nutrient requirement, water, protein, fat, then vitamins, minerals, fibers and carbohydrates, all those will be covered in next class. This is a very basic idea or basic class for the owners as well as the students. Now coming to the pets, you know, dog and cat are pet animals. So the dog and cat, they belong to order Carnivora, means meat eating animals, okay, the carnivora. But if you have a close look, then the dog is basically omnivore, okay. They can be on vegetarian diet as well as non-vegetarian diet, but you see, this is omnivore, that means you have to give both vegetarian and non-vegetarian. They are not herbivore, okay. So and the cats are true carnivore. Cats cannot be maintained in vegetarian diets because they need some amount. Apart from that, there is also some requirements when I will discuss individually the energy, the protein, fat, the carbohydrate, fiber. There I will explain the special cases of cats. Okay, so cats actually need some more nutrients than dogs. So they need preformed vitamin A. This is mostly found in animal livers, whether chicken or mutton, the goat or sheep livers, animal livers, you will find vitamin A, because vitamin A is stored in liver. They are fat soluble vitamins. Next, arachidonic acid. You see, in case of dog, you will find two essential amino acids, the linoleic and the linolenic. But in case of cat, they need another one, that is arachidonic acid. They cannot form the arachidonic acid inside their body, so they need arachidonic acid. Also the amino acid taurine, okay. You must be knowing the essential amino acid AHILL MPTTV. I will discuss in the protein section, okay. So then apart from that, they also need taurine. Without the taurine, there will be retinal degeneration in cats. So all these are basically found from animal sources, okay. So you have to give non-vegetarian food to your cat, okay. They specifically need non-veg diets. You cannot maintain a cat in vegetarian diets. Next, some points to remember. The normal body weight, you see, dog, there are different breeds from small chihuahua to great dane. So their body weight varies very, the variation in body weight is very high, 4 to 80 kg. It doesn't mean there won't be animal below 4 kg and above 80 kg. This is average body weight, 4 to 80 kg. Whereas in cats, there is not so much of variation. So 2 to 4 kg, male cats usually weigh more, 3 to 4 kg. Female cats usually weigh less, 2 to 3 kg. Okay. Next, the birth weight. Due to high range of high variation in body weights, it may range from 120 grams to 550 grams, where in case of cats, it is mostly 90 to 100 grams. It is healthy birth weight. Next, rapid growth phase, okay, when there will be exponential growth. The first 5 months of age is known as the growth rapid growth period in case of dogs, while in case of cats, first 3 to 4 months. In case of dogs, you can calculate the growth 2 to 4 gram per day per kg. Here this kg is basically anticipated adult body weight. Okay, if the adult body weight is 20 kg, then the growth will be 40 to 80 gram per day. Okay, this is for dogs. For cats, it is 50 to 100 gram per week. There is not so much variation in body weight, so on an average 50 to 100 gram per week. Next, growth plateau. This is a phase when there will be slightly moderate growth. If you take the growth curve, okay, here you will take age, here growth, then first 5 months there will be rapid growth, then there will be a plateau. Okay, this is known as growth plateau. So growth plateau is attained in 6 months, I suppose. For first 5 months there will be rapid growth, then from 6 months it will be plateau. Next, in case of cat, it is 5 months. Then complete growth occurs 8 to 12 months for small and medium breed dogs, in 10 to 16 months for large and giant breed. In case of cat, the growth will be completed by 7 to 8 months. Okay. These points you should remember, because during this phase, specifically from this age, okay, they need high protein, high fat, high energy, everything in high. So you have to take care during this period. Okay. Next, why the nutrition is important. This is very small term, but this has very large meaning. Preventive and curative. For preventive, it can prevent many of the deficiency diseases, metabolic diseases, the good nutrition can prevent. Next, curative, if there is some disease and you are giving a very good nutrition, the response to the treatment is very good. So the animal will heal in a better way. Okay. Next, this is very important for the owners and the students who are watching. Reasons for nutritional problems. See, dogs can be maintained in commercial food or homemade food. Commercial foods are basically highly balanced. Okay, they contain appropriate amount of energy, protein, fat, vitamin, minerals, fiber and carbohydrate. They are well balanced. They are researched in laboratories and they have formulated some preparation. So they are basically highly balanced. But problem is, most of the owners, they cannot afford this commercial preparation for a long term. They can give for a puppy some up to age, like till they become adult, they can give some commercial foods, but after that, in a long run, they cannot provide the commercial food on a regular basis, because it becomes costly. So they go for the homemade foods. The homemade foods are usually not balanced. Okay, they do not make it balanced. Okay, so we will discuss here why there is a nutritional problem, specifically when the dogs or cats are maintained in homemade foods. First of all, imbalanced homemade diet. I discussed first that imbalance. I have taken three examples. Okay, if a dog or cat is maintained only in meat or rice diet, okay, you will find calcium deficiency. Even if you will face parathyroid gland problems. Okay, next, if you are maintaining only on raw freshwater fish, it is important in case of cat. Okay, in cat, the owners may give raw fish. Raw fish contains thiaminase enzyme, so there will be thiamine deficiency. Next, if you are giving only liver, okay, animal liver, whether it is from chicken or sheep or goat, if you are giving mostly liver based diet, there will be vitamin A toxicity, because vitamin A is stored in liver. So if you are giving more of liver, then there will be vitamin A toxicity. Second one, most of the owner, they don't know that some of the human foods actually not meant for the dogs and cats. So they give human foods. For example, the raisin and grapes, okay, it contains some unknown substrate still yet not confirmed, which causes the kidney damage. Next, chocolates. Most of the owners, they come to dispensary. When I tell them don't give chocolates, they tell me, oh, my pet is taking very lavishly chocolates. They, he or she is very fond of chocolate, but they don't know. You see, first of all, you should know nutritional deficiency is not an overnight process. Okay, whatever, even if some vitamin A toxicity or vitamin D toxicity, anything toxicity, it does not happen overnight. Okay, nutrient diseases take longer time. Suppose I can give example, arsenic. Arsenic is a nutrient which is required in very, very, very trace amount. Okay, but this is a slow poison, you know. If you are giving more than the required, it may not show its symptoms in a short span of time. It takes very long time. Okay, when it takes long time, you won't even notice, but your animal will be harmed. So any nutrient, they cause diseases in a long run. So if your dog takes chocolate for like 2 days or 3 days, it may not show any symptoms, but when you give continuously the chocolate, there will be problem because it contains methyl xanthins. You see, humans, they metabolize methyl xanthins in faster rather than in case of dogs and cats. They do not metabolize methyl xanthins in a faster rate. In chocolates, methyl xanthin is a broad group. In chocolates, basically theobromine and caffeine, these two are present in chocolate. These two are methyl xanthins. Okay, so what they do, they first, there will be GI signs, whether there is diarrhea or vomiting. But if they are not corrected, if the chocolate is not withdrawn, with time there will be tremors, even if there will be death. Actually, after tremor, there will be arrhythmia, then seizure, then death. Okay, next, macadamia nuts. Okay, this is specifically toxic to dogs. Even if there is a research in an article, even if 6 nuts, only 6 nuts can cause death in dogs. Next, onion and garlic. You see, this is very, very important. Most of the pet owners, they give the cooked food which is meant for humans. In human cooked food meant for humans, we use onion or garlic, but they are toxic to dogs because they contain a compound that is thiosulfate, which is very highly which can be easily metabolized by humans but not by dogs and cats, which causes oxidative damage to RBC, which results in anemia. Okay, if you will ask that which one is more toxic, then onion is more toxic than garlic. Okay, so do not give onion and garlic to your pets. Next, sugar free foods. There are some commercially availability in market as sugar free foods which contains xylitol. You see, all sugar free foods do not contain xylitol. The foods which contain xylitol causes liver damage in pets. So you need to understand there some foods which cannot be given to pets but can be given humans. Similarly, there is another foods with high fat. For example, the chicken skin. Okay, the chicken skin contains highest amount of fat. If you are giving to your dog this chicken skin, then it may develop pancreatitis. Okay, so these are all the things you need to understand. The third is owners with good intentions. Actually, I do not want to hurt the intentions. So owners with good intentions, meaning some of the owners, they want to maintain their dog as per their need. Like they want to maintain in an organic diet or vegetarian diet. Or vegan, this is a new trend, vegan diet. For them, as a doctor, I will say, please do not force your food habits to your pets. They are carnivores. They are supposed to eat meat. Okay, or animals, nutrients from animal sources. You see, vegetarian diet can be given to the dogs and dogs specifically, but in case of cats, you cannot maintain with vegetarian diet. even if dogs maintained with vegetarian diet can have some problems. Okay, in the next class when I'll go for energy and nutrients. Nutrients means water, protein, fat, fiber, carbohydrate, vitamin and minerals. There you will see that specifically protein. You see, most of the pet, even if humans also, they need, most important thing is protein. Okay. Most protein. The plant proteins. Protein can be from plant source or animal source. I am giving an example to make you understand why vegetarian diets should not be practiced in pets. Or vegan is not at all, I won't recommend vegan diet. Next, plant and animal. You see, difference between the plant protein and animal protein is the biological value. I will discuss detail with biological value when I will discuss protein. For now, you should understand higher the biological value means good quality, the quality of protein is very good. Okay, animal proteins have biological value very, very high. For example, if you will take example of egg has the highest biological value. Egg protein has the highest biological value. Comparison to the plant, they have very low biological value. Even if some animal proteins range from like 80 to 90 biological value, whereas plant proteins can come up to 60 to 70 biological value. Okay. When the biological value is less, you have to give more protein. Suppose for example, your dog needs 5 gram protein per day. Okay, if I am giving the animal source protein, then I will have to give 6 gram per day, so that after the digestion 5 gram is available to the body or available to the dog. But if I use the plant protein, then I have to give 8 gram per day because the biological value is less. Okay, only 60 to 70% will be absorbed. So if I am calculating 60, then 4.8 gram, like 5 gram. Okay, so you need to understand that the plant proteins are not of good quality. It doesn't mean that plant protein has no value, but their biological value is less. So you have to give some animal proteins. So this is all about the basic nutrition in pets, and I will discuss more theory like in the next class. So if any pet parent who are watching, so you can follow the next class. Okay, that will be more like theory for students, and you can understand. I will try to give the idea or concept in a simpler sense. So thank you very much. We'll meet in next class. Bye bye.